a man for the first floor. That was a full time house.
Fans, and welcome to the Houston Fieldhouse for tonight's ECAC hockey matchup. It's the sixth-ranked Clarkson Golden Knights and the Engineers of RPI here on RPI TV. And right off the opening draw, we get a shot in wide of the target by Elizabeth Chiguerre, a sophomore out of Quebec City. Quebec comes in with 37 points on the year, leads the team. Back come the Engineers, however. Jamie Grigsby trying to make a move, although she's cut off in the end by the back check of Pazlova. Puck goes in the air. Blake Oro's trying to find it. She can't. Turn back behind the cage. And it's Jozon Pozzebone, his senior, to work it up ice. Loose pucks. Gable tried to hand it off there. Lauren Gable into the corner. We worked out by Chiguerre. Up the wall to the point. That one skips past Pozzebone. And the assistant captain will try and track it down. The goaltender, Cassidy Sauvé, out to play it. The transfer from Ohio State is in her first season here. She's a grad transfer out of Whitby, Ontario. To playing with these Saints, she comes in with a 12-4-1 record, three shutouts on the year, 1.94 goals against average, and a 9.26 save percentage, as Michaela Capel will get a deep for RPI. Sauvé to leave it aside. Avery Mitchell, sophomore from Pickering, Ontario, plays it ahead, as Christy Pigeon will not win the race here, as Madeline Burnett beats her down the ice, and we get a stoppage here on the icing. 18:31 to go in the first period. No score. RPI and Clarkson. It's a big league weekend here for these Engineers. Only league games left on the schedule. They take on number six Clarkson Knight, and they host St. Lawrence tomorrow. Not ranked right now, but a power in their own right. Both teams from the North Country are once again having great years. Here's a faceoff win pushed to Burnett, who's back in the lineup after missing a couple games due to injury. The shot comes in. It was blocked on the try by senior Allie Tremblay. Behind the goal now, Ella Shelton for Clarkson will start things out. Shelton, another one of the assistant captains here for the Golden Knights, will work it all the way down the ice. Burnett's going to leave it here for Hayes. Clarkson wants to change. A short bench here for the Golden Knights as they dress one short of the complement of forwards, 11. And the shot comes in, tipped up in the netting, and we get a stoppage. 2:04 in. And a draw coming up in the RPI zone. Anyway, just 11 forwards dress and only 5 defensemen. You're allowed 19 total. The Golden Knights do, however, dress 3 goaltenders outside of Sauvé. In Kia Castanguay and Marie-Pierre Coulombe. Only the most difficult to pronounce backup goaltenders in the league. They are dressed. Of course, it is Sauvé in goal here for Clarkson. An icing against the Engineers will send the draw back down RPI's way. RPI dressing all 19 that you can, along with all 3 of their goaltenders. Lovisa Solander, of course, the senior captain from Sollentuna, Sweden, comes in at 5-8-4. As that one came in on goal, Kendra Feroli's going to move it into out of danger. And now Chiguerre back up the wall. Trying to hand it off there was Friis Hansen on for Schwalbe, and all the way down the ice. Does this have the legs for icing? It does. He'll send the draw right back down, and Schwalbe perks up at the whistle, says, thought we had time to get down there and get that. Anyway, so Solander's 5-8-4 with a 188 goals against average and a 946 save percentage. Face-off win here for the Golden Knights. They work it into the corner for Lauren Gable, senior from Kirchner, Ontario. Gable back on it, trying to make a move around Hansen, who's not having any of it. Good defensive play there by the senior from Copenhagen. And she'll get another chance to play it here. Left behind for Feroli. And now Kendra Feroli will shoot it off the glass. There's a collision at center ice as Friis Hansen went down. Now Josephine Hansen will work it up the wall. Turned around by Jaguar. Jaguar, stick handling, throws a cross-ice saucer pass onto the stick of Gable. A shot and a save by Solander. She's going to hold on to it there and get a whistle. First semi-chance of this game comes for Clarkson here. Talk about the top goaltenders in the country. Lavisa Solander is fourth in the nation in save percentage at 946. And recently moved up in the all-time saves record book as far as NCAA hockey is concerned. She's already the RPI leader. And is on pace for close to 3,900. Outside shot at 4,000. Here's a shot coming here from Lauren Severson, goes wide. Puck back out to center ice. Golden Knights have owned this series recently. As we have a whistle coming up here. All time, Clarkson is 24-5-2 against the Engineers. They've won 20 out of the last 21 as well. RPI's last win came November 7th of 2015 here at the Houston Fieldhouse. I believe Clarkson was ranked number 3 at the time. It was a big win then, and if it happens again tonight, it'll be more of the same for RPI, as they're looking to keep pace in the very competitive ECAC hockey women's standings. 4 minutes into the first period, and we have a center ice draw coming here. A little bit of an un-Clarkson-like season so far. They've already had two winless weekends this year, including last weekend, where they were in Belfast taking on Northeastern. They tied the Huskies and lost. So twice this year now, they've gone entire weekends without a win. The other one was when they traveled to Cornell and St. Lawrence. And I made that up because that wasn't in the same weekend. So it's the only time it's happened since 2016-17 that Clarkson hasn't picked up at least one win in a weekend. So once it happened this last weekend, prior to that, it was October of 2016, the last time they didn't win at least one game in a weekend, which is an incredible stretch, of course, doing so. Winning a couple national championships will help in that regard as well. Last year's team went 32-4-5. Or that was 2 years ago, excuse me. Last year went 36-4-1. Anyway, 14:52 to go in this first period. Taylor Schwalbe gonna try and work it out of the corner. Big glove down by Capel out to center ice. Shot in off a leg. Pops right back out. Shelton to play. Engineers holding tough here in the opening 5 minutes as it's worked into the zone and fed back out. Now Solander's going to leave it behind for Hansen. Waiting for it is Wraithby. Shots are 3-0 Clarkson early on. Sam Nolan tried to clear. She's bottled up in the corner. And now Severson, she scored a goal. Turned out to be the game winner on Tuesday against Syracuse. As RPI held on for a 2-1 win over the Orange. Clarkson moves it in on the far side. Cianfrano, a centering pass, one save and another by Solander. With that left pad, a good stop there. Keeping this one scoreless. Now a shot coming, tipped on goal. I think that came off of Weiss. Making the job a little bit more difficult for her goaltender, but Severson's gonna lift this one into the zone. Sauvé gonna play it out to center. A little too ambitious there. She gave it right away. And Griggs is going to get this one deeper. Patchy's going to chase. Good breakout here, although it hit a skate. Spoke too soon. Backhanded along for Rowley there. This one pops in the air. It'll be played there by Helgeson. Winning that puck battle was Burnett. She gets it deep on a race to the far side blue line. And now skated out towards center by Pozzebone. Pozzebone still on the carry. The defenseman walking her way in, all the way in. And it's finally cleared away. No shot, I don't think, came there. But Jozon Pozzebone showing off her offensive prowess there. She has just one goal this year to go along with 10 assists for 11 points. In 20 games, she has 60 points from the blue line in her career in 141 contests. Into the RPI zone. The scorer of her first collegiate goal last time out, Emma Hicks. She's going to track this one down. Left in the corner. Cycled down low by Schwalbe. That's a smart play by the veteran from Anchorage, Alaska. Although it's taken back over by Tia Stoddard. And they moved out to center ice. Hansen going to turn around quickly. Schwalbe shoots it in. Capel has to touch up. Won't matter. RPI changing anyway. And shots are 6-0. This one is 8 minutes old. Jaguar is going to flip it up the wall, hit the linesman. Feroli is going to fire it right back in. Sauvé hands it off. Now a pass to the line, out to center. Shot right back in here. And Clarkson just hasn't quite been as crisp as you would expect here. Just breaking out of their own zone. RPI's been able to just work the puck back in deep and force at least the Golden Knights to start over again. 200 feet from their own goal, which was your RPI and where you want them to be. Now Feroli gathered up again at another clearance, and that's what you want if you're RPI here, not allowing Clarkson to get the puck deep in your end. Just winning that territorial battle could help you out in the end. There's a stretch pass here, looking for Jaguar. She didn't look like she was too excited about it. Now she'll gather at the top of the zone, Jaguar. Turning, wristing a shot. Look, took a deflection over the top of the net. Now Gable. Twisting and turning away from Weiss. Lost an edge, cleared off the glass. Gonna be out of the zone and carried out by Wraithby. Taken over, however, by Taylor Turnquist, the junior from Blaine, Minnesota. And she'll turn it right back up ice with speed. Here comes Turnquist. Trying to make a move, lost it in the end, but picks it back up on the other side. Turnquist. Going to leave it behind the cage. Clarkson on the attack. Good find at the point. Wrist shot coming. Saved by Solander on the try by Keenan. Senior from Calgary, Alberta. Another one flipped into the side of the net. Knocked away. Picked up Schwalbe. Going to play it behind. Delaney Weiss for RPI. Freshman from Lake Forest, Illinois. Going to work it ahead off the stick of Andrick. And Andrick tried to throw it back to Capel. It's picked up again by Andrick, who had an assist on the primary assist on the Emma Hicks goal on Tuesday. Thrown through everybody, was tipped, so no icing, and Hansen's back to pick it up. Although plenty of pressure coming in the form of Gaudette. And it's one back here. Mariani to the point. Nearly lost a handle on it, Shelton. Eventually gave it away anyway. Now a good lead ahead pass to Grigsby, who went down along with the defenseman. It's picked away and a shot comes in from outside as Oros was trying to catch Sauvé out of the net. Now Severson left it, cleared out to center ice. Feroli working it up the wall. Grigsby, Clarkson making a partial change. Grigsby will throw it on goal. It's going to be held onto. This should be the first shot of the game for RPI. With 9:12 to go in the first period, no score. RPI and Clarkson. You're watching Engineers Hockey on RPI TV.
Visit www.rpiathletics.com for more information. St. Vans, there's only one coffee that can fall. Dunkin' Coffee, freshly grounded, freshly brewed all day. Stop by Dunkin' for a smooth taste from first sip to last. Dunkin' Coffee is brewed for you, made the way you expect. Dunkin', this is coffee.
Oh, good.
Face off in the Clarkson zone, worked up the wall. Good bit of hand-eye coordination. That puck took a little bit of deflection on Burnett, but she was able to keep it in on the backhand. And now the Golden Knights will move it towards center. Into the zone. Cassidy Vinkel, the captain, all the way in towards the net. It was picked away and cleared out by Capel. D-to-D pass in the neutral zone. It's actually Jaguar back there, or make it Turnquist, rather. Turnquist working his way in, throwing it out in front. Good stick tie up there. As Sokka wasn't able to get her stick along the ice. Now Vinkel across. A one-timer is hammered wide, hit off the back of the net. Going to be cleared along to the near side. Hayes took a hit behind the cage. They moved out towards the line, flipped back into the RPI zone. So it looked like Hayes might have been shaken up a bit, but she's back to her feet. Grigsby stick handling, going to throw it up the wall. Gathered up again by Clarkson in its own zone. Posabone up the boards, good connection. Pazlova, centering pass, off the post! That was Gable. That puck was not sitting flat for her. And it'll go down as an opportunity there for Clarkson. Now another shot and a save by Solander high off the glass. Just got her shoulder on it. Now Jaguar backhanding one in front. Engineers trying to clear the puck out of danger, and Grigsby's going to tie things up in the corner now. Played behind. Here's Weiss up the wall, kept in at the point. Gable centering behind the intended target. An RPI will clear to center. Good find is Oros. Blake Oros steps through a bit of a check there from Mitchell and gets it deep. It'll be swept around as RPI tries to change. Emma Keenan back to her. Good pressure by Wraithby. Severson trying to center a pass towards the line. Burnett's going to keep it in on the backhand, but he moved out on the carry. Good poke check there by Feroli. I thought it might have put Clarkson offside there, but we play on. Burnett bottled up in the corner here. Hits off the back of the cage. Feroli digs away there. Pigeon. Watched by Severson. Hands it off. Fed to the blue line here. Shot coming. That one goes wide off the stick of Turnquist. And now Turnquist across. Gets the return feed. Had Wraithby right in her face and played it off again for the shot from the far point that came from Turnquist. Race for the puck here. Burnett, good job to body off the defender. Pigeon, loose in the middle of the zone. Going to be poked at here. Still loose. Wraithby going to be able to clear this one out. Does not have the legs for icing. RPI trying to get a change. Clarkson trying to turn it around quickly. We've seen Sauvé a number of times try to start the quick break the other direction. Cianfrano shot and she scores. T.T. Cianfrano, the transfer from Quinnipiac, picks up her 11th goal of the year as she picks out the top left corner. It's 1-0 Clarkson. 59th collegiate goal for Cianfrano. The grad student from Oswego. Gives the visitors a 1-0 lead here. This one's kicked at and moved up the wall. Frizz Hansen gets it as far as center, where the Golden Knights take over again. All the way back to Sauvé. And that one to be latched onto by Rapaccio. She gave it right away to Stoddard. And this will be lobbed in towards Solander. She'll glove it, leave it aside. Weiss up ahead for Grigsby, past her. And I'm getting nodding here. It's going to be icing on RPI. Officials today are Terrell Rose and Matt Luther, the linesman. David Sanchagrin and Kevin Manley. Quick shot off the draw. And Solander's going to hold it. And we get an official timeout, 4:58 to go in the first period. It's 1-0 Clarkson. The draw, shot over the top by Gable. And Oro's gonna use the net here, trying to slow things down, leave it aside for Burnett. A little bit of pressure comes from Pavslova. A steal and a shot, Jaguar ripped it off of Solander, makes another save. And now walking right in, Gable, that one's blocked over the top. Bit of a firing range here for Clarkson right now. Now Gable in front, turning and shooting! And a save, I think, by Solander. Might have hit Burnett. Either way, another opportunity there for the Golden Knights, trying to add to their lead. Goes by the wayside. This will be able to tell us this top-down look. Well, maybe not. I lost a view of it. Folks back home could tell. There's a shot and a save by Solander, headed towards that near post. I had a big ad in my face when I was trying to look at the scoreboard for that replay. But you folks back home probably got a good look at it. That's what happens when I don't turn my monitor on. Monitor's on though, so I'll see the replays like you guys will. Puck in deep. Hansen leaves it behind. Up the wall by Weiss. On further by Tremblay. Back to the RPI line. Thrown into the skates in the middle of the ice of Cianfrano. Fed right back in. Now a quick shot across. It'll be moved out to center ice. Tremblay ahead. Capel walking in. She pulls up top of the circle. A shot and a save by Sauvé. And that one's held on to. Good rush by RPI there. Getting the shot off. Sometimes it's baby steps to get an offensive zone draw. See what you can do there. Face off here. Capel, well, kind of flubbed a pass back to the point. That allows the Golden Knights to skate back the other way. Wrist shot here. That one's blocked down. Burnett up the boards. Flipped right back into the RPI end. Here's Burnett. She'll use the end wall on an indirect pass. Wristed right back to her. And now up ahead for Grigsby. Came off of Shelton. And all the way down. Worked up the wall. Here's Vinkel. Carrying, plays it ahead. Steered on goal. I think it was the defenseman there, Turnquist. RPI breaks back the other way, trying to send it across. A good find. It hops off Oro's stick. She'll try and track it down, although she's being pinned up against the corner boards. One back there by Grigsby. And taking the Clarkson defender out of the play, lost the puck, and now it's going to be tracked down by Hansen. As we had a near collision there, Oro's just spun away. Weiss into the zone. Flip back out to center. Weiss again. Engineers have to touch up and do. Shelton's going to go D to D here. Down the middle. Giguere. Hand it off. Paves the voice. Oh, shot and a save by Solander. And the save totals are adding up in this one. That is the 15th save for Solander in this period.
We hope you enjoy the Engineers' Pride for the remainder of the RPI Women's Hockey season.
Face off here. Friis Hansen had it for a moment. Now Burnett, the sophomore from London, Ontario, former Bluewater Hawk, going to work it along for Friis Hansen. Sauvé behind. Now up the wall by Pavzova. And now Capel for the Engineers. Gets it deep once more. Pausabone. Oh, near giveaway, and Severson tried a little toe drag top of the zone. If it worked out, they would have been in business. Now back comes Severson. She'll pull up at the point. Up the boards. That was Wraithby. We're going to get a penalty here on a board, I think. Body checking is the call. And RPI is going to go on the power play. Wraithby was hit along the wall. Seen and called here. Who did they get? Pavlova. Michaela Pavlova in the box. On a part of East Czech Republic.
Michaela Pavlova. 2 minutes for body check.
First power play chance here for RPI. Right off the draw, Orioles walking her way in. It'll be picked up by Capel, the forward working the left point here. Hansen across, Rapace in front, redirected just wide. A good chance there by Grigsby. Just put it wide in this RPI power play. Already showing us something here early on. Orioles behind the goal, Grigsby spins it up the wall for Capel. Up top for Hansen, pressure comes, played on further. Here's Rapace, very aggressive is this Clarkson penalty kill. And the Engineers are doing a good job so far keeping the puck moving. There's a touch off the defenseman there, the penalty killer, and that was touched by Capel. It's gonna be an offside, but not the end of the world if you're RPI. Getting a whistle here. Because it would have been a clearance anyway. One of those situations where the official could and probably wouldn't have gotten too much of an argument of calling intentional offside. But nonetheless, here we are, 55.6 to go in the first period. Minute 20 on the RPI power play. Engineers on the man advantage this season, 6 out of 59. That's 10.2%. Clarkson's penalty kill is at 84.7. Sauvé behind the goal. Going to fire it up off the glass towards the line. Kept in by the skater Feroli. Nice play by Kendra Feroli. Furley's going to walk in and take a shot that's hammered wide. Another try hit into the midsection there of Pausabone and finally cleared by Clarkson. Great keep by Feroli and the good patience as well. A lot of times you see a player keep the puck like that, they'll just blindly throw the puck into the zone, but she kept her wits about her and actually got off a decent shot, just kind of missed wide. And it'll be moved in by Tremblay. Down low it goes. It'll be swatted around. Kept in, no. Severson has it hop off her stick. And that'll do it for the opening period. Clarkson gets the first goal of this one. TTC Inferno with her 11th of the year at 14-11. Shots were 16-3. Golden Knights after one, but RPI trails by just the single goal. We'll be back with a second period in just a bit. You're watching RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. Penalty is over as we're underway in this second period. RPI still on the attack. A centering pass intercepted by Shiguer and cleared to center. So Clarkson survives the first penalty of this game. And they maintain a 1-0 lead as Blake Oro is going to get the puck deep. Back the other way, Gable throws it through the middle, looking for Gaudette. It'll be played by Pazlova. Good stick by Hayes, just jammed it right in there. To the point, slap shot coming over the top of the net by Mitchell. Lifted along behind the goal, now Schwalbe. Off the boards, good find Hayes. Capel just took off, didn't realize the puck was still trailing her. And now Gable. Poked away by Schwalbe. She's met now by Delaney Weiss. Gaudette. Here's Weiss again. Chipping it up the boards. And now it'll be bottled up at the line, hollering for too many men. A backhand shot, save made by Sove and Severson with an opportunity there. A bit of a confusion. RPI was changing right where the puck was, right in front of the bench. And Sove stuck out that left leg to make the stop on Severson, who came flying in looking for a rebound. Sove was able to cover up pretty quickly there. Face off, Burnett, high slot, wrist shot blocked down. A good try there by Tremblay, who does have a good shot once she's able to get it off. So far, just the one assist so far this year for Allie Tremblay, the senior of Hayward, Wisconsin. Now stick handling in front, ran out of room, Vinkel. Into the skates of Burnett. Tried to clear the zone, shoved right back down low. Good find though. It's moved along down the middle. Gathered up by Turnquist. She'll walk her way in and take a shot. It's held by Solander. 17-15 to go in the second period. RPI with the better of chances so far here in the second.
We'll see you again today at 2 King Street, downtown Troy.
Clarkson leading, however, 1-0. They've also hit the post, hit the crossbar conjunction in that first period. That one sent across. It should be offside on RPI. And it's tipped in on goal and a cover up. I thought the engineers were offside there, but no whistle went. It turned to another opportunity there. Although you have to think, if RPI did score, Clarkson now the opportunity to challenge, and I think you would have seen it there. And they're not letting RPI change here. I think it was just too late, says Matt Luther. But anyway, another shot there for the engineers. They only had three in that first period. They already have two here in the second. Rapace in the corner with Grigsby. Pops free to Weiss. She couldn't quite corral it. Mariani was applying pressure as well. Avery Mitchell across and now out to center ice. Pigeon. Dumped in by Kelly Mariani. Senior out of Mississauga, Ontario. Bouncing puck behind the goal. Cianfrano. Looking left and right over her shoulder, finally comes to her from Mariani. Now Capel couldn't quite track that one down. Fed back to the RPI zone, Clarkson changing. RPI could have numbers here, but Burnett elects to shoot it in off of Capel. And that will erase any opportunity there for an odd man rush. Would have been kind of a 4-on-2, kind of a wonky one. Anyway, back comes Clarkson here. Shiguer off a skate, trickles wide. Not sure if that was the intention, but still a dangerous opportunity. Now another shot and a save by Solander. Bouncing puck to the side of the net, fed through again. And it's swatted around, looking for Pazlova. Now a hard pass off the stick of Hicks. Sends Clarkson right back into the zone. That one hit the skate of Burnett on the centering try. Pazlova to the point. Now Shelton across. Jaguar, her pass partially broken up, but gets to the intended target. It was the defenseman Turnquist pinching in. It'll be swatted around. Jumping out, and here is Tremblay for RPI. She'll cross center and get it deep. RPI will complete a change. Coming up on 5 minutes into the second period. It's been a pretty back and forth affair here. RPI certainly showing up for this one. As this one hops right to Grigsby, a shot over the top of the net. Good defensive stick there in the end by Shelton. Now a shot coming from the point. It's seen all the way by Sove. And she holds on. 14:48 to go in period number two. The Engineers with some extra jump here in this second period. They trail by one still, but certainly have played to a much more even period so far than the first went to the Golden Knights. There's a certain amount of off factor you have to get over. A shot and a save. What an opportunity there for Oros right off the draw. A quick snapshot is turned away by Sove. And another opportunity here for the Engineers. Flipped up the wall, turned back into the RPI zone now. Sokka around the net. On a Cochrane, Alberta. Here's Vinkel trying to center, broken up. Grigsby ahead for Oros. She runs into Pazabone. And it's chopped right back out to neutral ice. Fed in by Stoddard. Hansen takes a look around. Plays it through Vinkel. On for Burnett. Burnett will take a look up now and feed it off the skate of Grigsby. Carried into the zone offside here. That looked like a closer play than the one they let go a couple minutes ago. 13:52 on the clock, second period. It's 1-0 Clarkson. You're watching RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. Faceoff coming up here, neutral zone. Shot in by Weiss. In the corner, Schwalbe. She's bottled up by Shelton. And now they dig away for it. Good connection to center. Cianfrano going to flip it past Hansen and Chase. Weiss there defending through her skates. Picked up again. Another centering feed in front, and it's fed right through. An opportunity for Mariani. Good stick by Hansen breaks up the play. Mitchell going to keep it alive. Hansen up the wall. Freeze Hansen, couldn't corral it. Now Gaudette gonna pin Hansen up in the corner, knock her down. It's underneath the skates of Gaudette. There's a player open at the point there, centering pass in front, a shot off the post, and the rebound goes wide. Another opportunity, I think it was Pazlova again. I think she hit the post in the first period. I have to check on that. No, another centering pass goes all the way through. Golden Knights buzzing here in the second. Mitchell, a slap shot that goes well wide. Jaguar. Out of the corner. Stolen away by Capel. Golden Knights have to touch up, and they do quickly. Carried back in. This is Lauren Gable walking in. Shot over the top, off the glass, into the circle now. Jaguar lost the sight of it. Schwalbe's going to play it along for Grigsby just off the bench. Chips it past the defender and tries to work her way in. Looking for an interference call. It doesn't come. And a good poke check there. Should be offside against RPI. That goes uncalled. Rapacci, a shot right on and a save made by Sovink. And now we get Grigsby in a tussle there with Keenan. Checking on that play from previously, that was Gable who hit the crossbar in the first period. I misspoke. So now two pipes have been hit, and we have penalties each way. Looks like we're going to play 4-on-4.
Put them in separately. Yep. Okay.
Clarkson penalty number 21, Emmett Keenan. RPI penalty number 6, Jamie Grigsby. 2 minutes each for roughing. Time of the penalty, 8 minutes and 19 seconds.
This one dumped in. This should, no, not going to be icing. As we play 4-on-4 for a full 2 minutes, a couple of roughing calls. Mitchell's open. She takes a shot that trickles wide. Painslava up top. And a shot and a goal. Pazabone from the top of the circle. And that's twice now that Clarkson has been able to beat Solander high on that blocker's side. This time it's the defenseman, Jozan Pazabone. Senior with her second goal of the season, her 15th of her career. Another look at it here. Up over the shoulder of Solander is in the butterfly there. Can't label that one too much better if you're Pazabone. It's 2-0 Clarkson here. It's an even strength goal for the Golden Knights. As they look to break out, they can't. Rapacci a shot, looking for the redirection from Oroz. And aggressively, Sauvé all the way out of her crease to defend that one. Now Feroli plays it behind for Hansen. Hansen trying to throw it near side. Good connection here is Severson. Severson pulls up, lost the puck, taken away by Gable. Now a 3-on-2 for Clarkson if they hurry. Gable into the skates of the defenseman, Shelton. She'll just turn it back up the wall and look to cycle. She found the skates of Burnett. Now Jaguar on the backhand, fed across. And that one never got to Solander, I don't believe. 17 seconds left, a 4-on-4. A centering pass comes from Gable all the way through. Penalty coming up on RPI. It's going to be a power play here for Clarkson. 9:51 on the clock. It's going to be a trip, I believe. Going to send Feroli to the box. Or a hook. Hooking on Feroli. So it'll be 4-on-3 for 11 seconds, and then 5-on-4, barring a Clarkson tally.
2 minutes 4. Time of the penalty, 10 minutes 9 seconds.
Engineers try to slam it out on the far side. 5 seconds to go until we have a more standard power play. Wrist shot coming, saved by Solander. Trying to cover up. And the puck's going to be cleared, but not out. Another shot blocked down. So the two first matching penalties are done, or coincidentals. And now Pazabone across, wrist shot, saved by Solander. Back up top. Around the net, a centering pass, they score, a power play goal for Kelly Mariani. And it's 3-0 Clarkston with exactly 9 minutes to go in the second period. Fifth goal of the season for Mariani. And nothing Solander could do about that one, a bang bang play in front of the net. Nearly got there. In fact, she looked like she at least got her leg across to the post, but it might have been over the pad and under the glove. Fed all the way down. Now back the other way. We get an icing call here on Clarkston. Shot here, blocked down. And now Oroz. Turned back around by the Golden Knights. It's centered. Helgeson. Pulled it back, takes a shot. Penalty coming up. Who's this going to be on? Interference. As Hansen's shaken up. It's going to be on Clarkston. It's going to be on Vinkel for interference. Power play for RPI, 20 to go in the second period. Offensive zone call. We'll have that power play in just a moment. You're watching RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. Off coming up in the Clarkston end here. Second power play chance for RPI. They are 0 for 1. Grigsby tied up in the corner. Nice job to shield the puck there. Apache is going to play it around behind for Oroz. Blake Oroz, junior, one of the two top scorers for this RPI team. Back up top for Capel. Now Hansen. Capel trades places with Josephine Hansen. Off for Hansen, a slap shot, a save, rebound Rapace, another stop there, puck is wide of the net. And now a chance for Clarkston to break. We got a whistle here because the goaltender, Sauvé, is in some pain. We will have a stoppage here, 7:49 to go in the second period. 3-0 Clarkston, RPI knocking on the door here. Sauvé with an excellent save coming across to make that second stop. Puck stayed out of the net. And I think it was reaching for that puck, so they got hurt. But we will step aside here. And Sauvé is attended to. You're watching RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. back to action here. New goaltender for Clarkson. As the Engineers are on the power play. Hansen, a wrist shot, save made, rebound Grigsby, and that one's turned aside as well. Great opportunity there for the Engineers trying to get back in this thing as Hansen puts it wide. It'll be cleared out off the skate of Capel. And out is Solander to swat it up ice. Turning up quickly is Rapace. She'll take a shot, it's blocked there by Shelton. Tremendous save by Kia Castanguay, who's making just her third appearance. Sophomore from Ipswich, Mass. And now Tremblay across the line, poked out to center. Gable with speed into the zone, pulls it back, takes a shot, deflected, good block there by Rapace. She went skates first into the wall. Penalty is about to expire. As it is over, Gable back in. Engineers 0 for 2 on the power play. And really a big penalty kill there for Clarkson. You have a cold goaltender go in, obviously due to the injury to Sove. And she comes in and makes a tremendous save for her first stop of the game on the kill. It's probably the most difficult situation to come into if you're a goalie, especially one with a little experience as Castanguay. But she makes the stop there. Moved up the wall, but kept in. Cianfrano across. Wrist shot coming, blocker saved by Solander. Bouncing puck swept to the wall by Severson. And now moved up ahead by Hicks. Here's Megan Hayes. Steps around the poke check of Cianfrano. Gonna cross the red line, dump it in. Race forward here. Fed along by Pausabone. Kept alive by Hicks there. Andrick is gonna gather along the boards. Gets it right back after she threw it off the back of the net. Was given another chance by Mariani. Now Mariani down the middle, stick handling. Well, looks like she put herself and a teammate offside. Very liberal here with her offsides in this one. Cianfrano around behind. Centering pass in front, a block down. Picked up by Grigsby. Poked to the boards. And now gathered up here by Weiss. Another one of those situations where if Clarkson would have scored in that first possession into the zone, RPI would have really thought about challenging. There's a shot, kind of a knuckling changeup there from Winkle. Didn't have a lot on it, but Solander had to stick with it and make the save. Now it's cleared off the glass and down ice. All the way down. This will be icing on the Engineers. 4:20 on the clock, second period. Shots are 27-12 Clarkson. And they continue to lead 3-0. A power play goal here in this period as well as an even strength tally. Face off here, Hayes. She's tied up. Tried to work it back behind. Helped on further by Rapace. Now Grigsby has Oro's breaking. And is able to get it as far as center ice. Stoddard takes it off from Sokka. Puck goes in the air. Sokka, or Winkle rather, gets loose, feeding it to the side of the net, looking for Sokka, comes all the way through to Stoddard. Stoddard up the wall, waiting for it was Hansen, or Hayes rather, she'll lift it up the boards. Chopped at by Grigsby. Doesn't go anywhere. We worked back here to Weiss. Up the boards. Hansen tried to step up. Swatted past her, but in good position is Weiss. She'll spin it around behind. Hansen to pick it up for RPI. Hansen will turn up the wall. Finds Hicks. Severson to the rescue just off the bench. Goes down to a knee to keep it alive in the neutral zone and eventually gets it deep. Nice play there by the sophomore Severson out of Rockford, Illinois. And now Severson has it. Little pass ahead looking for Wraithby. Too far for her. Played around behind by Shelton. Mitchell for Clarkson, up the boards. Glove down by Wraithby and handled at center, finding Feroli. Feroli will try the far side, through Severson, no icing here. Waved off immediately, Emma Keenan to play. Around the net she goes. Keenan through the middle, broken up by Capel, carried on further. Pazlova poked off her stick by Burnett. Gable out of the corner, walking right in, a centering pass and a good tie up by Feroli. Jaguar with her hands up after that one. Thought she was maybe being held. The officials say play on, and if you're Feroli, there's not much else you can do but try and tie up there, hang on for dear life, and that's what Feroli did, denying Jaguar on the far post. Jaguar second on the Golden Knights with 14 goals this season, only behind Lauren Gable, who has 16. Top point getter, however, with 37 through 20 games. Anyone averaging almost 2 points a game. Tough to keep them off the score sheet. Stoppage here. I'll update you on the scoring in this one. Started in the first period, 14-11, an even strength goal. TTC in front over, says fifth there, but that's not right. 11th goal of the year. From Cassidy Sauvé, the goaltender. Then it was 8:59 of the second period. Jozon Pozzebon, her second goal on the year from Michaela Pazlova and Avery Mitchell. 2-0, then a power play goal, 11 minutes even. Kelly Mariani from Pozzebon and Taylor Turnquist. That's where we stand. 3-0 Clarkson. Shots are 27-12. Update that. Well, I did. They are 27-12 still. Center ice draw here, five skaters aside. Final 2 minutes and 10 seconds of the second period. Engineers really could have made it a game, and they still can, but had a power play with the new goaltender in there due to the injury, Castanguay. They had a great opportunity, but Castanguay made a great save, I think on Grigsby, to keep this one without a goal on RPI's side of the column. And he kept it to 3-0. Now a 3-on-2 for Clarkson. Cianfrano in. Drop pass here. Wrist shot. No. Good defensive stick. Hansen and Severson combining there. Now Cianfrano at the blue line. Tried a little handoff. Pozzebon. Or Pozzebon rather down low. Given back. And now Severson pried off her stick. Cianfrano lost an edge. It's worked up for Oros. She's now bottled up just across the blue line. Minute 15 to go in the second. Rapace digs away, tried a cross ice feed. It's broken up in the end and cleared by Shelton. Will this be icing? Should be. And it is. Clarkson was trying to make a change there. They will have to send those folks back onto the ice. With 1:01 left in the second, faceoff coming up in the offensive zone. RPI has generated some offense from some draws. Blake Oros, namely, has a quick shot off the faceoff. We'll see where she sets up. More from the right side than here on the left. They like finding Oros at the top of the circle for a quick one.
1 minute remaining.
Puck comes free. Oros finds it, trying to walk her way in. That was partially denied. Still loose in the dot. Good poke by Rapace. 50 seconds to go. Trying to work it down low for Oros. Swatted away by Stoddard. Stoddard on the move. Cut off by Rapace. Swatted to Grigsby. Finds Oros. Oros trying to snap it back across, and it was broken up by Cianfrano. Move back in by Grigsby. Left behind by Pozzebon, and now a stretch pass here, looking for Cianfrano just off the mark. Covered up here by Solander as they're looking for the home run ball, and nearly worked out. Cianfrano was breaking. Ended up just out of a reach, trickling in, and Solander was able to cover. Engineers and Saints are at it tomorrow afternoon, 3 o'clock puck drop here at the Houston Fieldhouse, St. Lawrence. And the Engineers, these two teams played earlier this year. There's a quick wrist shot that went wide. Saints getting the best of RPI in that one by a 5-0 score. This is the same scoreline that RPI and Clarkson played to up in Potsdam back on November 3rd. As that's going to end the second period, 3-0 Clarkson after two. See if the Engineers have come back in them in the third. We'll have that for you here on RPI TV in just a bit. about to get underway. 3-0 Clarkson on top of RPI. Glad you're joining us here on this Friday evening in Troy, New York. RPI is going to get it deep here. Chozon paws a bone. They're trying to work it up the near side. Well, she stumbles and falls down. Oros picks it up and turns and shoots, and a save is made. Oh, boy. Castanguay with another big save. A lot is being asked of her in this one. Although the three-goal cushion, I have to think, gives her a little bit more of confidence. It's only 2-1. Maybe she feels a little more pressure here, but so far, so good for the sophomore from Ipswich, Massachusetts. Near the North Shore. This is going to be fired all the way down. It's going to be icing. Look, sounded like it was tipped. What do I know? 19:03 on the clock, third period. RPI already with a big chance here.
It's men's hockey alumni and freak out weekend.
Clarkson's starter, Cassidy Sauve, looked like she, after taking another look, she might have pulled a muscle reaching for a puck, making a great save, mind you, on a penalty kill to keep this one, to keep RPI off the board. Late in that second period, she had to come out of the game. Looked like she was in a lot of pain. Anyway, she was replaced by Castanguay, who immediately came on and had to make another stop on that very same penalty kill. But Clarkson able to kill it off. All the way down it goes. Centering feed in front, loose in the crease. There was a bit of a tie up there. Shot comes in and a stick save by Solander. Lifted up the wall. Broken up there. Braithby couldn't get it out. And throwing her body ahead there was Severson. Nothing comes of that. But the engineers do get it in deep. Golden Knights going to try and work it out. Here's Gaudette. Shot in deep by Cianfrano. Clarkson going to complete a change. Grigsby touch pass center ice. Good stick lift by Oros, but it heads right to Mitchell, who fires it right back to Weiss. On for Grigsby. Cross the red line and sweep it in. Took a little bit of a hop that Castanguay wasn't expecting. She had to reach back for it. Now Burnett, a slap shot high and wide. Caromed around to the half wall and out of the zone. Vinkel over skates, gets some help. It's chipped in on goal. A little skip into the glove of Solander. She'll hold on for a stop at Chuncer. 29-14 Clarkson. They lead 3-0 here. It's going to be wrapped around and played out through center ice. Hansen tried to stick handle back the other way and lost it. And now moved up ice. Wristed in from center by Shelton, and that'll be held onto. Now stick handling, another move, shot just wide. Good opportunity that time from Christy Pigeon. Would have been a highlight reel goal as she kind of dangled her way through some traffic in front of the RPI net, but in the end her shot went wide. And now Shelton. Stolen away at the blue line by Grigsby. Severson now throws it through the low slot area. Cianfrano off the Deflection off the wall. Carry it back the other way. Tried to center. Looking for Pigeon. Now it's gloved down. Mariani centering. Fanning on the first try was Pigeon. Second try backhanded behind the goal. Feroli has her stick knocked out of her hand. She'll go back and try to pick it up. Gathered up here by the Golden Knights. A little spin move to get free by Vinkel. Joining the play on the far side. A shot never came. That one does. And then we got a penalty coming up here. It's going to be a hook in front. I think they, what did they get? Severson? Or was it Hansen? My guess is Hansen. It's going to be a hook on Hansen here. It's going to be a power play for Clarkson. They're one for one.
RBI penalty number 9.
This will come trickling in on Solander and she'll cover up. So Clarkson can just about put this game away. Then get a fourth goal here. Their second power play opportunity. Here's Lauren Gable, turning and shooting. It's blocked by Capel. Schwalbe pushing it ahead, shorthanded. Joining her is Capel. Schwalbe trying to find Capel, and it's just down in front of her. Couldn't reach it. And they'll restart things here for Clarkson on the power play. Engineers do not have a shorthanded goal this year. And now Weiss gonna maybe lead a 2-on-1 with Grigsby. Grigsby in. Shot coming, and it comes trickling in. Still loose, and where is it? Don't think it crossed the line. But Castanguay did not quite handle that as well as she might have wanted. I thought it was loose. It looked loose. But I, in the end, as I said, I don't think it ever crossed the line. Castanguay was able to recover and hold on for a draw. Top down looks can get us the best angle at this. She has it. Oh, it's trickling. Yeah, not close. Probably about 10 inches from the goal line still. This is going to be lifted all the way down. Good look from our camera folks here, as always. It moved along. Mariani in the corner. All the way around it goes. 36 seconds to go on the power play for Clarkson. Turnquist up top. Pausabone. That one went right through Stoddard. Mariani to the point for Turnquist. Stick handling, still Turnquist. And a backhanded up the board. Stoddard. Lifted to the near point. Pausabone gets it back. Pausabone looking. Shot by Mariani, hit the skate of Feroli. 5 to go on the power play. Stoddard can't corral. 2-1, that'll do it. Shot comes in, save, rebound, pops out. Rapace can't clear. And now Feroli gonna try and skate to the wall. Mariani beats it to the puck. Rapace gonna take a look and just chip it out to center ice. But RPI kills off the penalty. Clarkson now 1-for-2. But the time continues to tick away on this third period. 13:20 to go. Golden Knights still up 3-0. Skating to get free, Ellis Shelton. She'll cross the red line, dumping in on goal. A right pad stop is needed from Solander. Off the skate of Weiss. Centering out in front, all the way through, kept in by Mitchell. A wrist shot by Mitchell, and it's held onto by Solander in traffic. And we get a stoppage and a break. 12:55 to go in the third period. It's 3-0 Clarkson. Winkle off the draw. Working it deep is Shelton. Oros. Across for Delaney Weiss, and now ahead for Apache, who shoots it in. Shelton going to play it here off the end boards from Mitchell, too far. Oros. Oh, headlong. It was Apache, kind of her own doing. This is a good whistle, just to make sure everybody's okay. I don't think anyone's really at fault here. Apache went hard into the wall, and I don't think she hit her head, but it was an awkward fall, and better safe than sorry here. Looks to be all right. The worst case scenario, you get a whistle here, and the puck was underneath Rapace. And now we get a penalty coming up, interference on the draw. RPIs to go on the power play here with 12:19 to go in the third, and really an opportunity for them to get back in this game. This is their third power play chance. Gable's going off for interference, and it's one of those plays that you hear about officials before the year sometimes. They're trying to make a concerted effort to call more of those, and it was a number of years ago they started doing it, and sometimes it seems on and off. But anyway, power play here for RPI, fed across, and it'll be corralled here by Capel. Michaela Capel off for Hansen towards the line, does keep it in. Grigsby's going to track this one down. RPI's power play has looked dangerous so far against this rather aggressive Clarkson penalty kill. Now a shot and a goal! Jamie Grigsby fires it home, and it's 3-1. Castingway is probably going to want that one back. She looked like she was in good position. It wasn't a great angle for a shot. I think she just beat her five hole. Engineers now 1-for-3 on the power play. The goal for Grigsby is her fourth of the season. And that's just what the Engineers needed here in this one. Because now you have the young goaltender, Kia Castingwhite, just thinking about that shot maybe a little bit. After making a couple of real nice saves in her early on in her outing, started in that second period. Castingwhite gives up maybe a bit of a soft one here. It opens up the door here for RPI. Although they'll need to keep the pressure on. And I feel like Clarks is a team that, if they have to, can kind of switch things into an extra gear. So RPI has to be careful of that as well. Then we got an offside whistle. So you kind of have to play, you know, more aggressively because you're down by 2, 11-10 left. You're getting chances, but be aware that there's the top two lines, especially for this Clarkson club. Supremely talented. Neutralized draw. Lauren Gable works it back for Pausebon. Now Keenan, back to Pausebon. Good find here, Jaguar. She'll pull up. Works it up the boards. Hansen trying to clear. Kept alive, Jaguar. Centering all the way through, flipped just wide. On the other side, that was Paisleva. And now Hansen, she'll cross the blue line, took a whack in the hands. Jaguar to carry it back out again, 2-on-2 with Gable. A dangerous duo working into the zone. Jaguar gives it back, and sliding into the end boards was Schwalbe. Kind of inadvertently breaking things up as she forced Gable to the ice. Now Keenan going to try and clear. She's tied up by Hayes. Now another collision. And the referee's letting a few things go here. Borderline interference. Here's Grigsby trying to center. Gets it back. Grigsby turning. Try it again. A shot that's blocked away. Glove down by Oros. To the point. Weiss, a quick one-timer. Hit a skate. It'll be carried on out by the Golden Knights. Flipped off the glass by Helgeson. And around behind, Rapaci picks it up on the other side. Helgeson goes down, up ahead for Grigsby. She loses an edge and falls. Plays it ahead for Oroz, who tries to go off here. And she ran into Vinkel. Things are getting a little bit testy here with 9.5 to go in the third period. 3-1 is the Golden Knights lead. Shot comes, blocked down by a skate. Picked up by Vinkel. She runs into traffic to the point. A shot by Stoddard, and that one's, I think, blocked away off of Schwalbe. Stoddard picks it up on the other side in the corner. Back to the point. Kept alive there. Shelton has stood up. Now it's gathered up again. Fed across as an engineer down. Shot and a blocker save. It's Hansen. I didn't see what happened, but there's no penalty coming as the Golden Knights still got a shot off there. It was away from the puck, which was makes it difficult. I didn't see at all what happened to Hansen. And we'll have a stoppage here with 8:59 to go in the third period. It's 3-1 Clarkson. You're watching RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. Another look at, oh boy, that's a shoulder check. That's a blindsided hit. That's a penalty in men's hockey. So they missed that one, for sure. Hopefully Hansen's all right. I've talked about it before. Hansen's one of the toughest hockey players you're ever gonna see. So I would not be surprised if she's back out there. Anyway, hopefully Hansen's all right. We got 8:52 to go. Shot in, slowed up by Solander. Going to be cleared up the boards. Grigsby. Oroz, they're offside. She backpedaled into the zone a little bit early. Shots are 36-17 in favor of the Golden Knights here. Feroli across, and now going to be shot in by Weiss. Gathered up by Rapaci for a moment. And all the way in deep it goes. Shot comes in, took a deflection off a skate. Kind of slowed it up for Solander. She was still able to kick it aside. Now her wrist shot's blocked. Capel gonna jump on it, feed it off of Tremblay, and then the shot right back in. Bouncing puck at center. Turnquist can't corral, but Cable's gonna move it ahead to Jaguar. Jaguar makes a move, across, a shot and a save by Solander. It's flipped right behind her, but all the way through the crease. Now Turnquist, snapped a pass back to the point, a shot that's blocked by Feroli. Clarkson trying to reestablish a three-goal advantage. They're denied there, first by Solander, then by a block. Nice move. Puck pops in the air. There's a tie-up. Puck is covered now by Solander. With Pazlova.
Award-winning chili, all off the bone ribs, hand cut steaks.
In there trying to track it down. That rebound.
Legendary deals like this and these can be only...
Engineers did a pretty good job. That was a good form tackle by Michaela Capel on Bezleva, making sure that didn't happen. Wrist shot in, right pad stopped by Solander. Sokka to the point. Shot coming off the post and in. A point shot here from Emma Keenan. And she picks up her second goal on the season. The senior from Calgary makes it 4-1 on the 41st shot of the game for the Golden Knights. Good looking shot there from the blue line. There was plenty of traffic for Keenan. I heard the post. It must have hit the back bar along the ice. Usually it's padded, so it doesn't that kind of thing doesn't happen. But it came out of the net pretty quickly too. I kind of want to see that again, but of course, no chance to review now because they've already dropped the puck. Grigsby, Hansen. Swatted ahead. Possible.
And number 24, Taylor Sokka. Time of the goal, 13 minutes and 2 seconds. Four marks for the score, number 21.
The assists are to Vinkel and Sokka as it's lifted high in the air through the middle of the ice. The goal is Keenan's. Makes it 4-1, an even strength tally. Worked up the boards. Here is Grigsby. She has the lone RPI goal. Her fourth on the season. Played along by Andrick. And now Severson. Gloved down by Gaudette. Somehow escapes out to center. Gaudette on the move. Drop pass here. Shot coming. Saved by Solander on the chest protector. Gaudette leaves it behind. To the point now. It was Turnquist looking for the return feed in front for Keenan. For a couple goals in a minute there. Was not able to connect. Here's Hayes now. Going to shoot it around looking for Wraithby. Wraithby, center ice, good connection. Andre gets it deep. Good work. Kind of a cross between the third and fourth unit there for RPI on the ice, but get it deep and get a change. 5 minutes to go in this one. Drop pass here. Fed all the way through. Along the far side, that was Gable. Now back comes Capel with speed. Capel a shot, and that one goes wide. Caroms all the way out to the point for Weiss, who gave it away once, but keeps it in the zone. Keenan high in the air, into the crowd. And a stoppage. 4:41 left. Shots are 41-17, Clarkson. So Lovisa Solander. Another big night as far as saves are concerned. 37 in this one. No soft ones either. Here comes Jaguar, a partial breakaway. Jaguar walking in, and she never got the shot away. Great play by Hansen. The kind stripped the puck. That'll be fed in by Grigsby. There's an opportunity by the wayside for Clarkson, and Jaguar just doesn't look like she's skating that fast, but she pulled away nonetheless. Now Jaguar again, a shot and a save by Solander. She'll hold on there. We get a stoppage. 4:08 left. It's 4-1 Clarkson. 4 minutes to go. Faceoff win for the Golden Knights. Shot came from Shelton. It was blocked down. Picked up there. And Oros lifted along nicely for Grigsby. Stolen away by Shelton. D to D pass. Mitchell ahead through everybody. Picked up by Feroli, who sends it back to Oros. Grigsby, wrist shot. Blocked away by Shelton. Picked up by Oros again. Blake Oros. Going to shoot it around. Burnett waiting at the blue line. Shot on goal, redirected by Shelton. It was a great redirection. If you're an RPI fan, Shelton nearly tipped it home on her own goaltender, but a good glove stop. And Shelton says, thank you very much. That was all my fault. Mitchell's in the box here. I didn't see for what. A body check here on Mitchell sends the engineers back on the power play. Engineers are 1-for-2 so far. Now a chance here and a goal. Jaguar shorthanded. It's 5-1. Stopping on a dime and backhanding it past Solander. Right off the draw for a 5-1 lead. Another look from the top down. Nice move by Shiger. Pick up her 15th goal on the season. Really ending RPI's thoughts here. Power play with, you know, about 4 minutes on the clock. You think if you can get a quick one, you do have a chance, but Shaker quickly put an end to that. Here, move back up top. Here's Hansen. A slap shot coming. Rebound loose. Shot and a goal. Save. Shot on goal, I should say. A save, and now more. From Oros and Casaguay took a little bit of exception there. It was a high shot from the blue line. Casaguay, you kind of leapt for it to try and stop it, and then the rebound fell to Oros, but Casaguay had that near post covered to the point. Hansen tried to play it across, blocked out to center ice by Jaguar, of course. And now Hansen backing up in her own zone, spins away from the forecheck pressure. Jaguar runs into her again. And Jaguar is just going to hammer this one deep. Rapace off for Hansen. 55 to go on the power play. The fourth power play for RPI, I beg your pardon. Grigsby trying to backhand it across. It's intercepted and cleared by Keenan. And now a race for the puck. And just barely getting there first was Hansen on Cianfrano. And Cianfrano did her job and just leaves the ice. On comes Tremblay. 22 to go on the power play. Shot and a glove save by Castenguay. So a power play goal and a shorthanded goal for Clarkson here in this one. Have helped create the separation. A 5-1 lead with a minute 55 to go. 20 seconds to go on the power play. That should be all but squelched here. There's a collision here. Burnett puts Gable into the boards. And we're going to have a body checking call as Gable's now slow to get up. Getting helped up by Painslava. So the power play is over with 11 seconds left on it. Thankfully, Gable's able to skate back to her bench on her own.
RBI number 22, Madeline Burnett.
Had some dangerous looking hits here in this game. Some uncalled, some called, and you know, Burnett might be lucky here to be only getting the two. is that that was pretty reckless. 4-on-4 for 11 seconds. Thornquist down low around the net. Penalty's over. Power play time now for Clarkson. Pausabone. Behind the intended target, picked up by Oroz. Makes a move, and they're still shorthanded. Nice find. Here's Hansen walking in. Takes a shot that goes wide. And it'll be kept alive on the far side by Oroz, who just swats it right back down low. Wrist shot coming, that one's blocked as well. Minute to go in this one. Turnquist, a shot, that was blocked. Another try to flex. That one hopped along in the crease for a second. There's a shot in the pad saved by Solander from the blue line. A shot by Pausabone. All the way out of the ice, 37 to go. Pausabone gonna pick it up. Giguer, stick handling, nice move. Elizabeth Giguer, all the way in, takes a peek, throw it into the skates of Pazlova. Shelton, Giguer in front, Pazlova shot in the left pad, saved by Solander. Back to the point again, Shelton, 11 to go. Gable, good to see her back out there after taking a spill moments ago. Now Severson moves into the zone with 3-2-1. That will do it for this one. Golden Knights take it 5-1. Golden Knights improved to 15-5-1 on the year. They're 6-3-0 in ECAC hockey play. RPI now 7-10-4, 4-5-0 in the conference. RPI back in action tomorrow, 3 o'clock against St. Lawrence. You can watch that one live here on RPI TV. I want to thank all of you for watching. This has been a production of RPI Women's Hockey on RPI TV. Have a good night.